everybody, welcome. Yeah, let me just pin this mic. Yeah, there we go. So first, let me start with Lai Mohammed. Mohammed. That's another Mohammed. I like the Mohammed. Our president too is Mohammed, because they put you for Mohammed. There is a Mohammed. Oh my God. I don't know what's happening for this my house right now. I'm sorry. My dog is a crazy ass motherfucker. My dog is mad. He's like, if that play, go forget. Okay. Let's go. Me, I'm serious here. Yeah. I don't serious now. So quickly, Lai Mohammed, see, basically, he won't regulate social media because now, through social media, lies they spread for society where they lead to death and destruction. But the truth be said, this is just scapegoating of social media. You know, the reason why they don't like the lying on social media is because social media allow poor people to lie to. Social media allow ordinary citizens like you and I to lie to. Lying is a human, see, well, not lie as in the name of lie, I don't say lie is a human thing. Lying, not lie, you know, because I like the way Nigeria Information Minister name is Lie. You can't write Nigeria script, man. You can't write it. I mean, it's too much. This is too much. You know, lying is a human trait. Everybody they lie. Listen, the Nigerian government are liars. Individual people are liars. Everybody lies. Me and my way here are the lie. Everybody lies. So this actually madam. Oh my God, my poor wife. Yeah, ma. She don't cut. Oh, okay. So this is just scapegoating, right? You know, like now our social media come, my lie begin to, you know, day everywhere or spread. People have been spread. See, without social media, now all Nigerians believe say we play match with India, where India win us 99-1. Say now that match make FIFA ban India for football. Say every shot where India play like this, the ball will turn to lion. Yeah, you youngins, you generation, you millennials, you might not know this story, but anybody that is my age mate in Nigeria knows this story I'm telling you. How about the story of Toda Balogun? Say he takes shot, tear person belle, play shot for stadium, the shot, come be brother or something like that. See, don't let anybody railroad us with this lying story. You know, as if not only social media, the only problem they have with social media is that social media allow poor people too to lie, for poor people lie to spread. Before, not only rich man lie, they spread. You know, another lie, you know, way normal media, my father, they say Fela is crazy. Not me, normal media, they talk that one that time. The problem is that they cannot control social media, like they can't control everybody on it. But you see, regulation, normal media, they know everybody will get out. Everybody now, guys, they regulate themselves. I'm sorry, I know this is not an endorsement to what I want to do now. Doesn't mean all you people here should be behaving like this. So I'm just doing it because, you know, doing sake. And it's not sponsorship. In fact, look away, look at my dog. You know, so you don't see what I'm doing. Back to the show. There's this drink. I don't want to, because there's everything and an endorsement. Make everybody call the station who is endorsing. I don't do that one. Yeah, so back to the story. So this whole Lai Mohammed story and social media, when they talk since, you know, social media lying and the Nigerian society and community has been together like 5 and 6 since forever, you know. This not be how I put out. This not be a new thing, you know. But also young people, old people, men, women, children, everybody, we need to stop allowing these people to use social media as a way to scare us into submitting our freedom. Like, don't take, we should stop paying at sea. Now, our level of commitment, because we want easy organization, you know. Many people say, they tell me, say, what should I do for Shrine, you know, we should have taken it online instead of doing the press conference, or just held the meeting online. I don't tire for online. These people cannot, we cannot allow our government then. May they relegate political gathering to online only. You know, we have the right to assemble on ground too. You know, if you just tell us more, no meet on, you know, like, who are they to say that? You know, so we cannot in any way, shape or form submit on ground, the ground, to the oppressor, you know. And how about all our poor brothers and sisters who know if we afford data? Data in Nigeria is one of the most expensive in the world. I mean, per capita income, if you compare, it is so expensive. The moment we want to do only online gathering, it means we won't, as usual, relegate the poor people out of the discussion. And I would say happen for the NSAS movement be that, because everything was done online, we not carry the poor people along, and not be every poor person get money to come Lekki or come Alausa, where most of us gather. And that one come miss, then to not get the right to do it in, to vex, because Nigeria they vex everybody. So then to they vex for their own area, the way they can vex everybody, say they be hoodlum. You know, it doesn't say we day on ground too, we organize to them, help them arrange, and everybody day together, you know, even for their own areas, there will have been more, even this protest for which they go on up till now. You know, so not we just day online only. You know, we need to begin to address ourselves. You know, I mean, poor now, somebody may not address Nigerians as poor, but poor on economic reality, poor on economic, not be insult for me, not be insult. You know, that's why I won't even discuss African socialism next year on this issue before the hour is up. You know, poor not be insult for my own eye. You know, poor on the situation of many people in Nigeria economically, it's just facts. You know, I mean, and that won't not diminish their value as citizens. The problem we get in Nigeria is that so many people, they diminish people because they are poor, you know. Whereas economic poverty should not equal human poverty or undignified existence, you know. Me, I don't go play Miss World about that, you know. It's just that we tie their own economic reality to their human reality, and which is wrong. I don't do that neither, you know. Back to what they telling now, you know, make you ask Lai Mohammed, where normal media day, where social media send us to war for, send the world to war for Iraq? Not be all the normal media, they lie, say Saddam Hussein get weapon of mass destruction. Now social media talk that one. All international media, not be they talk that one, you know. All over the world, traditional media has been lying to humanity all through our existence. So men they no come tell us say because people they lie for social media, then they incense, then they cause violence. Now lie, before social media they violence everywhere in this country. You know, that's what this government they talk with two sides of the mouth every time, two sides of their mouth. Lie don't kill them. The year later when they send me, say make I not go do my meeting for Shrine. They say that because of peace, we are infraction, there will be infraction on the peace against. They say, that because of we disturb the peace, we are not against the peace and the building of Lagos. They say they rebuild Lagos, they want peace. Same people go for Amuwo Dofin, Oshodi, begin to attack Okada riders. We don't say organize. You know, I say Nigerian people don't liberate themselves from police brutality. These police people know the year word. And I said, I'm going to just go pack the Okada. they go they cry for road, they go they fear now. They don't leave they don't liberate themselves. They can't go there, go find trouble now. Those ones begin scatter the whole Lagos when they say they did. Mm-hmm. So who where did be other story? Where did be other story? Where did be other lie where they lie? So we know the truth, we know the truth, I beg. So make Lai Mohammed pack himself somewhere within your year story. Traditional media lies. The problem with violence in society, if violence full society, is because those that can afford it want it to be like that. Finish. Those that can afford violence want it to be like that. Case closed. They invest more in such. See, if we are looking for thug in Nigeria, who is the number one employer of thugs in Nigeria? If police want to investigate the action of thugs in Nigeria, not be their employer, because which people did they work for pass? Which people? No, because all of us sit down for a year with a blow big grammar and I say we don't know the truth of what thing they happen for this country. Which people they employ thug? Well, all these things, man, let me just go back to what I want to discuss today, because I want to try to keep the live as short as possible. May I try fee post time, you know. So Movement of the People, an alliance of organizations where they work towards the emancipation and liberation of Nigerian people for a very long time, you know, and this being a time where we believe, say, we truly need to capture our energy politically, you know. So NRMC, they go on doing what it's doing, but this is an alliance to show, say, we are also working towards doing what we're doing. You understand? The work of MOP no stop the work of NRM, you know, in any way, shape or form. NRM is definitely there to strengthen organizations like the MOP. So what we all need to do is organize ourselves. MOP is organizing nationally, and so will NRM organize nationally, you know. So people ask me, why socialism? You know, why for NRM we discuss socialism and say socialist countries are not free, people are not free to express themselves? I say, well, Nigeria is capitalist, people are not free. Look at a country like Saudi Arabia, is capitalist, people are not free. You know, capitalism and socialism not be the real reason why society not really free. You know, the true essence of societal freedom lies in the culture of the people that run that society, you know, the ideas where they want to make it dominate. You know, for us, socialism simply means, say, another man has no right to make a living of the existence of his brother. Let me say, if you get idea, you know, if you do your business, make your money, you know. But no longer will we allow for people to make money of the pains of their fellow citizens, of their brothers and sisters. The homelessness of your brother cannot be the reason why you are rich. The sickness and death of your sister cannot be the reason why you are rich. You cannot be sitting at your house praying for your brother and you start to be sick now. You understand what I'm saying? The education and enlightenment, knowledge is for the people. Knowledge must go to the people free of charge. Nobody can sit down on education and be collecting money from the people to impart knowledge that is of the people to them. There are certain industries in our society that is the commonwealth of everybody, that must work for the benefit of everybody. You see, and in those things, we cannot allow anybody to sit down at those gates and profit of those things. Those things must be socialized for the benefit of everybody, so that even though you are poor, you are not living in poverty. In Europe and America, they are poor people, man. In Canada, anywhere you go in this world, they are poor people. Yeah. But it's the socialized distribution of commonwealth that allows there to be dignity, so that your dignity is not tied to your economic reality. Because it's not everybody that can make it in business. Forget the lies that they tell all of us. Not be everybody for this Nigeria go make am. Not be everybody God go bless. As they don't say God bless, God bless. It's only people that don't work for their money and they say God they bless them. Go read the books of all the billionaires for America. They will tell you exactly how they became. Now in Nigeria they do God now bless me. Because why? They should be us. Now us they should be. Take should be. For them to should be, the guys should be us. You understand? This now NRM Lingua Franca. They didn't give it a doubt. Light I see you there. Should be. They should be, they give us the should be way. Somebody say yes, America is a socialist country. That's a fact. America is a socialist country. So compare America to all the countries for Europe who get socialist net in terms of quality of existence. America are the only country waiting for first world nation when you get health care. You know? Look at the homelessness in a place like LA. You know, but America, they say, is the richest country in the world. You know, but for us, wealth has to be in the value of the in the quality of existence of your people, not in value day, not be the amount of money where some people feel packed for their own pockets. You know what I'm saying? You can be poor, say you are not a millionaire, but you can feed yourself, you can feed your children. We can no longer allow only a few people to control the food of this country, of their own, creating hunger. Not only are those rich people that they praise, that then they cause hunger for this country. It is Bill Gates down with Dangote. I see one post from Bill Gates page. I didn't follow him. The post shall reach me. Where they just say, in there with his friend Dangote, and they are discussing ways to end hunger in Nigeria. Then you say, who did this mugu? I said, tell the Dangote where they next to you. Say, if he reduce in food price, there will not be hunger in Nigeria anymore. The people are hungry because they cannot. Not say food no deal, my brothers and sisters. This food deal that they waste time, that they export, that they export food for Nigeria. Go look all our. We are growing more food in this country than ever before, but it's all for the highest bidder. Nigeria, they say the government is making they close border because they want to now lie. It's for the highest bidder. Our yam, na export, rice, everything. No, not rice, but yams, cocoa, plantain, all those tropical things where we get, where they look, then they carry and go, and so they don't send us. Knock you price, like say you they earn 10 million naira a year for food. Nobody can eat. And you are there making money, say you're a big man. Children are dying in ignorance. They condone all the education. Because you know you have to understand, say there's a reason they where our government no they invest in education. They say government has no business in business. But business has business in government. Because all business they bribe government officials to make sure that they pass policy where they favorable to their industry, to the detriment of the majority of the people. So for Nigeria now, if you know if you afford private school, your child cannot be wise. Your child cannot have school. Your child cannot grow up to compete with their own children. The children of those that can afford private school are already ahead of all the children of those that cannot. Why some people make money off that system? My own be saying, if you get idea that will add to your nation, me at the time say, see me, Shehu, I'm more valuable to Nigeria as a musician than any of these our billionaires. I'm more valuable. Forget this what they tell you. You see me, Shehu, any money where I bring enter this country, now extra to Nigeria, anything we get before, me at the output need. I tell the band one day, I say, you are more, in my own eye, you have added to this country. Without you, all those your songs we like no go exist. Without me, all the songs we are write no go exist. We don't add things to this country where we take they see our own money. All these people, what would they? If Otedola no exist, what would Nigeria not have? If Dangote no exist, what would Nigeria not have? If Tinubu no exist, what would Nigeria not have? This is what I keep asking people. Say all these people don't amass all this kind of wealth. Waiting, they don't add to this country. What will we miss? What will we miss? Say we're not going to see person who will sell us the most expensive cement in the world. Ni? Abu no go see anybody they sell us the expensive diesel. Ni. Abu no go see anybody we go dey collect a hole for our hand for every corner. We, no, waiting we go miss. This is the question. If all these bank chairman and MD no exist, what will we miss in the banking? What innovation? What will we go miss? This, I see you have to find what have you added that if it didn't exist, we will not have. Justify this your extraction. Because what I believe say. If people for this country be human beings, because they don't be human beings, they be animals, that's what they dehumanize us to. Don't ever think that they are human beings. They are monsters. That's why they dehumanize us to make us like them. What will we miss? Because me, I believe, say, not be say they put our ancestors not put crude oil for inside ground. For only some few people to live large. The crude oil is there for everybody to live well. Our ancestors did not give us fertile land for only some people to grow food and control it. He gave it to all of us to eat well, everybody to eat well. So if I'm giving some people the control of these things, it is their duty to make sure that those things service everybody, not just to make their own lives better. See, I don't mind, even it was saying that even they give us enough to feed us. It's just that they give us enough to be okay to just live a life. See, dignity is all we demand. A life of dignity. When Nigeria know they rush free rice. Nothing. They corner everything that belongs to us and then they use it for themselves. Without creating the means for us to even have, as in 40, 60 years, now we don't deal like this. Now, Nigeria, 60 years, not one problem solved. Not one. Not one problem. Not one. Not one problem. Then the only identity where the woman could get is the individual identity. The individual identity. You only know yourself. Rugged individualism. Your identity is your first name. That's it, not me. Me against the world. Anybody can make it. It's me. Whereas 90% of us, 95% of us, every generation, fall back into poverty. After they sap all your youth energy, take serve them. You go to say you go make her. You be. We. The new set will come. So come and take your place. The new set will come. So we where we did like this for here. We must demand at least a scientific approach to African socialism in the way where we say these people can no longer sit down on waiting belong to all of us for only themselves. The level of development where they don't create for their individual life doesn't match the level of development in the country. So when you have everything that belongs to the country in your hand, it is your duty to use it to benefit the whole country. Now the lie where they tell us be that government has no business in business. So if we, the businessmen, are given the chance to run these things, we will run it to the benefit of everybody. It will work well. I bet you not tell me what way they work well. They say, now our politicians don't sabi, private sector is better. I say, private sector, first of all, for Nigeria, there's no such thing as private sector. That's what irritates me. Because private sector and public sector, all now one. Now Nigeria money there everywhere, scattered everywhere. All now one. Tell me one private sector where they function well. Now telephone ni. See now telephone ni they work well. Education ni. Wait till which private sector the bank. We won't kill us. Now, hey my god. See now bank they work well. Which private sector? See now downfall because we get private transport and private transportation is downfall. public transportation, which is also private, is BRT, but it's everything is private and public together. I don't care. But which one is better? Nadafo or Molue, private? No, wait till, say that their airline, is their airline, private airline, better in what way than what we had before that was Nigeria Airways? What is, now the airpiece gone, what we say is private, airpiece, they say that Nigeria money be airpiece. Say airpiece is a piece of us. Say that the healthcare they okay need for private. More than tell me which private, what, which, these people are all about self. They give us the minimal, the lowest level of service, and they collect the highest money for it in every level. So we won't create Nigeria. We say only your idea can make you money. If you get idea to make your, to help your community, to do something, bring something to your community in exchange for capital, fine, there's space. Look at China. China is socialist, but they have free market. Don't be free, you can free market. But what will not allow is the freedom for people to live in poverty, because that's the only freedom that this capitalism offers us in Nigeria. The only thing we are free to do in Nigeria is to be in poverty. You are free to be in poverty, and you're also free to self-destruct. But any other freedom, are you free to go to a good school in Nigeria? They'll say capitalism make us free. Wait, are you free to go to good school? What is this freedom? The freedom to misbehave, to do anyhow, to drink anyhow, to smoke Colorado and die on the floor. That will be freedom. That will be freedom. But I always ask people, say, this freedom. The only freedom you are exercising as a Nigerian right now is the freedom, one, to make Europeans rich. Two, the freedom to live in poverty. And three, the freedom to destroy yourself. Finish. Because there's no freedom to good school. There's no freedom to good job. There's no freedom to good healthcare. There's no freedom in relation with our security forces in this country. So what are we free to do, Gongon? What is this freedom, Gongon, that we always shout about as African people? I don't know about Europeans and white people that live here or that live in their, but me, I'm relating to you. That's how they speak Pidgin. I relate to now. I relate to myself as a African boy, as a Nigerian boy, as a Lagos boy. My reality. What are we free to do? What is this freedom? Can somebody tell me one thing that they are free to do that is progressive? Where's the freedom? Now they ban me for strike. So, only if to meet, and I'm not free to meet. They say if I cannot meet with the people online, meaning that only we ourselves still. We must not build a bridge to the poor people of this, the majority of this country. So we want to talk about real freedom. The freedom to stand for something. The freedom to believe in yourself. The freedom to develop yourself. The freedom to develop our nation. Where are those? That's the freedom here. That's socialist freedom. The freedom to have dignity. Telling me about freedom. They come, they say Nigerian people, we are not united, we don't love ourselves. See me see trouble. How can we love ourselves when we don't understand ourselves? And I've said it before in this my life here. Understanding ourselves can only happen when we have done something great together. That's how people know one another. Knowledge and understanding, you know somebody to understand them, and to know somebody, you must do something with them. And to, the more you do with them, the more you know them. And when you now do something great with somebody, you never forget each other. You know yourself, so you now understand yourselves, because you've accomplished something together. You understand? These people have never invested in the development of this country so that we can accomplish something together as the Nigerian people. That's why, you see, my own motto personally in my life is to resist. Because we got to resist the oppressor. You know? Where they're they? They've not developed this country, so we have not built anything great together. So that's the reason why we don't understand one another. Forget unity. Unity is, what do they call it? Some kind of utopist ideology. Unity. Who unites? Inside family, God, who unites? Family, they unite. Who send anybody message? You know, in some families, most of our biggest enemies are in our family. Actually, we African people, because as I said before too, the slave master slave relationship has been normalized in our relationships as African people. So we hate ourselves. And they tell you the way some parents they beat their children for Nigeria, the way African people they beat them all over the world. There's some kind of self-hate because your child is you. That's a part of you. That's a manifestation, a new you. They would have beaten, I say. But that same parent, give him Oyibo pikin, make him raise. Give him white child. Say, raise this white child. You not go beat him one day. I guarantee you on my life. So what are we saying here? We must revert. We cannot touch on too many topics. You know, the part of my topic today. But we go talk plenty talk, because talking, they say we don't like to talk. Talking and action. At least without talking, there's no planning. How can we plan without talking? How can we plan without talking? There are many things we have to reveal to ourselves so we know the direction we are moving. So everybody doesn't think, hey, we are moving in the same direction, and we are not. No. Somebody say I am a cripple entry socially. I say so. Saudi Arabia is not socialist. How many creative spirits is there? How many creativity do they allow there? Is it because of socialism? If your culture is enclosed, then whatever practice you do will be enclosed. Africans have always been socialist and have never stopped our creativity. You understand? We are not preaching an oppressive entrepreneurship. That means that you are bleeding your community. Is not entrepreneurship, is parasitism. What many people call entrepreneurship here is parasitism. Say now entrepreneur, you say you they carry money where politicians thief, come they London through some kind of business for your community. That's not entrepreneurship. But now the most business in Nigeria is basically money laundering. When the time comes, we are going to say the truth. We are going to bring Nigeria's money out of everywhere that it is. Hotels. How many hotels does one street need? How many entrepreneurs must build hotel for one street? Before we're going to say we have serviced our hotel needs enough. How many nightclubs must there be on one street? How many entrepreneurs must open a restaurant for one area by force? I mean, I don't know other things to do. Because there's not an hospital they build everywhere. Every neighborhood will get maybe one or two hospitals. But then you have 200 hotels. Wait till it happens. We will play the entrepreneurship. We will entrepreneur well. And if you want to be entrepreneur, you will be entrepreneur well. Better entrepreneur. You'll take your money, you go look. Because government will provide the programs. The office will go say, I get money, investment planning, you know, we go help us to make sure, say, people will be entrepreneur, we be entrepreneur well. You know, entrepreneurship, we say, we are plugging into creating industries of manufacture. Instead of us, all these individual entrepreneurs, to go, they open different shops for Computer Village, to they sell different foreign things. We go direct them with government aid. Government will provide the technical know-how, the facility, then provide some money and some labor, and we create the things where they create those things they want to sell. That's a better way. Then they bail my brother, entrepreneur, when they build cheap hospital for poor people. Eh? Oh yeah, entrepreneur. I mean, we go redefine entrepreneur to suit our needs of development. You know, understand? Not be all this crazy entrepreneur what would they see here? Because this one na madness. What would they call entrepreneurship? Is sometimes it's just madness and money laundering. Let's not forget money laundering. Money laundering. Let's not forget that. Mm-hmm. Because all these are entrepreneur. So, for me now, moving forward to us as motherland people right now, I'd always ask one question, say, if in my generation, like, I'll be 38 in 2 months, so 80s kids, maybe even some 90s kids, I say, nobody grandfather, they homeless. Yes, everybody in my generation, their grandfather get house. Now, by my father generation and my generation, homelessness begin spread all over Africa. So how will we be able to achieve all these things back in the day? Because in the middle of this quite, you know, balanced society, we still had quite successful people that were able to add things to their community, and made wealth from that. You know what I'm saying? So those things are part of the things where we must incorporate into our new ideas what we have to bring into this country. You know, free market cannot be free market to exploit my own people. No. Entrepreneurs, businessmen, people, our business must live in balance both with people and with nature. Because this is the only part who really distorts for Nigeria at all. The destruction of our natural environment by these business practices, unregulated business practices. Many of us will grow for Lagos. Remember saying for Lagos, we wear sweater, go school when we're young. For January, where cold will come. More than look the whole environment now. Look at all our beaches, dirty, all the rivers, dirty. I go for Bayelsa. This Yeye Mohammed, really they talk about criminal. If you're a criminal, you can. I went to Niger Delta. The whole waterway, I see everything full of oil, man. That's the worst criminality in this country, man. When are they young? If they travel for express, everywhere is full of forests, pristine virgin lands. Go look at all our trees, and then they cut them. No regulation, then they go destroy whole forests. Animals killed for no reason, no protection. All our gutters exposed. All our environment everywhere polluted. Who is held responsible for all of that? Criminality against nature. Okay, forget us human beings, they suffer for Nigeria, where they don't destroy our life. Where is the respect for nature? So I understand that, yeah, the debate could continue on why MOP, NRM, believe in a socialist foundation. In fact, to be more accurate, African Scientific Socialist Foundation, because we believe that it is by giving the people power over the control of their own, of the means of producing their own future. You understand? We have to give the people the power of the means and the control of producing their own future. We can't allow only a few people control it, because obviously they are driving it into the wall or off the cliff, and then all of them wear parachute inside the car. because they make all of us just believe. When they say this car, they go this cliff. Say this car will fly, come up for this cliff. All of us know we have parachute. Too. Only them, the people they drive, now only they see we have parachute. Only they see they tell us we don't get parachute. Say make we believe them when we have parachute. Say they don't go fly off the cliff. And even if the bus fly off the cliff, say the bus go fly. And we know parachute. Can you take this chance? This is what they are saying. Take, this is what capitalism is. So people with parachute inside a bus driving fast towards the cliff, telling the rest of us with no parachute in the bus to believe them that the bus will not fly off the cliff. And even if it flies off the cliff, it will fly. I'm telling you. It's not more than that. You know, all the old entrepreneurs going to be their business, not be government contracts. What is the entrepreneur business in Nigeria? Not be government contract. Government contract here, government contract here, contract here. Everybody is chasing contracts up and down. That's why they cannot talk. They can't say anything. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. Because contracts mean you go with the entrepreneur when they sell tailor clothes. When they sell agbada, your shonshu, your best customer is politician. Even if you don't have politi- if you don't have big man customer, you will not be selling clothes for nothing for the rest of your life. So everybody needs the contracts. So what is the entrepreneur when it's the same money everybody is circulating? Hey, let's just please let's do what we do. Let's do what we are doing. You know. So African scientific socialism is definitely the solution. Somebody says it's not the solution. Socialism is definitely the solution. Creating a welfare base, a social welfare base for all Nigerians. You know, representative of us and our needs, so that people can live in dignity. It is not by force for everybody to drive Rolls Royce. The lie they are telling us now is that everybody can drive Rolls Royce, and it is not true. It is not true. What everybody can be promised is dignity. Finish. All of us can have dignity. Dignity. Nobody can promise you $1 million. Dignity. Dignity in your life, dignity in the life of your children, dignity in the life of your family members. Dignity, that's all that is missing in all African existence all over the world. We live an undignified existence. And that's the cocoa, that's the foundation of the problem. Nobody wants to give us dignity. And those that are selling out our dignity for money are telling us that money is the answer to everything. Whereas even people with money in this country have no dignity. They have no dignity. With all the billions they have in their pocket, no dignity. So because they cannot attain that level, they are making all of us behave in an undignified way to seek that which that they have, that rubbish that they have. But at the end of it all, it's all an undignified existence. I beg. Everybody will say, because they don't do some kind of propaganda for 80s about socialism to make Russia look bad. Russia, they do communism. Russia is European. They are, this is African way. We are not copying Russia. We are not copying. We are living in the way of the original way. DJ Sena, dignity, palliative, entanglement. I beg, don't kill me. Exactly. What kind of person with dignity will hide Indomie? It is the undignified hiding of the Indomie that is making the other people live undignified lives. Because if they are shared that Indomie now, will people be rushing like animals for food and raiding? I mean, is it not undignified to be a billionaire and still be hiding rice? Is it not undignified to be a... Anyway, so that's it for today. May I see whether some questions there? I feel take some questions. May I see what's in there for my question box? Okay, there's some question about NSAS unity, and I think that's the most important one I can take. Well, you know, as I say, there's an understanding that something must be done, and that is what everybody is doing. You know, and I think we'll meet at the point where we meet. You know, everybody should just stand fast. Thank you, everybody, for being a part of this live today. I really enjoy myself, you know, but we'll continue discussions later, you know. And yeah, the struggle continues. Liberation generation.